In this segment, we're going to look at what the definition of an upper triangular and a lower triangular matrix is. So we are basically reviewing some of the things which you need to know about solving simultaneous linear equations. So upper and lower triangular matrices come into the picture when we talk about LU decomposition method of solving simultaneous linear equations or the Gaussian elimination. So let's go and see what an upper triangular matrix is. So an N by N matrix, a square matrix, is called upper triangular if the elements, if the following elements are zero, which is A sub ij is equal to zero for I greater than j. So then it'll be called an upper triangular matrix. So what does this mean? So N by N matrix A, I should call it, so that this is the corresponding element of that particular matrix. So N by N matrix A is called an upper triangular matrix if A sub ij is equal to 0 for I greater than j. What does that mean? So let's take an example. Let's suppose I have a 4 by 4 matrix, and I write as 23, 6, 0, minus 5, 2, 1, 3, minus 6, 20, and then 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 here. So what you're basically seeing here is that any of the elements where the row number is bigger than the column number, they are all supposed to be 0. So those are the elements which are below the diagonal. So these are elements which are below the diagonal, and they're all 0. So keep in mind that the upper triangular matrix is based on which elements are 0, not the elements which are non-zero. So all you have to look at is that if the elements below the diagonal is this one, where the row number and the column number is exactly the same. So any of the elements which are below that diagonal, they have to be 0. So for example, if you're looking at this element here, this is fourth row, first column. So the row number is strictly greater than the column number, and you have to have a 0 there. So any of the values of aces where the row number is strictly bigger than the column number, it has to be 0. No exceptions. Only then you can call it an upper triangular matrix. Keep in mind that this 0, for example, here does not make it upper triangular or not upper triangular. It is the zeros below the diagonal which make the matrix to be upper triangular or not. And so based on that, you basically look at if the row number strictly greater than the column number elements are all 0. So that's what's an upper triangular matrix. Let's go and see what a lower triangular matrix is. A N by N matrix A is lower triangular if A sub ij is equal to 0 for I less than j, I strictly less than j. So let's look at an example of a 4 by 4. So we're going to take a 4 by 4 matrix here, just like we took it previously for the upper triangular matrix. And let's suppose we have 20, minus 5, 3, 2 in the diagonal. And let's suppose we have 10, 0, 6, 0, 0, 3 here. And then we have to have 0, 0, 0 here, 0, 0, 0 here, and 0 here. So again, for determining whether a particular matrix is lower triangular, you have to look at what is above the diagonal. And if all the elements above the diagonal are 0, then you know that the matrix is a lower triangular matrix. It does not matter whether elements which are on the diagonal and below the diagonal are 0 or non-zero, what they are. What determines whether a matrix is lower triangular or not is based on what are the elements above the diagonal. Again, when we say I less than j, that means the row number is strictly less than the column number. So for example, if you look at this element here, that is first row, third column, and you're finding out that the row number is strictly less than the column number, and that has to be 0. And that is the case for all the elements where this I is less than j, and that's what you're seeing here, that they are all 0. And that's what's a lower triangular matrix. And that's the end of this segment.